sideline, trout line, sitting on a pipeline, waiting for the sun to shine. Snap beans, red beans, cornbread, and mustard greens, that's how we live and it sure feels fine. Well, you can't change us, that's the way we know. Cajun people live like they did long ago. So join the fun, live off the land, 'cause there ain't nothing better than a Louisiana man. Tightline, trout line, sitting on a pipeline, waiting for the sun to shine. Snap beans, red beans, cornbread, mustard greens, that's how we live, and it sure feels fine.
Hey everybody, welcome to Cajun Living and Cooking. My name's Rodney Dupree, and today we got a neat show for y'all. We're at Santa High School. It's the FFA's annual plant sale. And let me tell you, we're going to go behind the scenes, see who's planting this stuff, see who's buying this stuff, see who's selling this stuff, and we're going to see who's growing it. So y'all stay tuned. Cajun Living and Cooking's fixing to start right about now. All right, y'all made it into the greenhouse here before anybody gets in. And they got some really neat stuff in here. They got flowers, vegetable plants, they got fruit trees. But they were telling me there's 13 different varieties, I believe, of tomato plants from all different sizes all through here. And these kids actually planted these plants, and they're raising money, and we're going to find out who planted it and where this money goes. But this is some really nice looking stuff, y'all. Some of these tomato plants is really nice. And what they do, they number them. So you'll come in here and you'll look at a chart and you find a number, like this is number 4. And then you'll look at the chart and see what kind of tomato it is. This is a 4, this is an 8. So it's different varieties of tomatoes depending on what you want to grow. And they have flowers and stuff also. So we're gonna get behind the scenes and see who makes this happen. All right, y'all, got one of the teachers. Let's get her name.
Hi, I'm Mandy DeLone.
And you're one of the FFA teachers here at the school.
Yes, sir. I'm one of the 3 agri-science teachers here. It's myself, Mr. Brennan Delk, and Miss Emily Manuel. We, with the 3 of us, we're able to offer a lot of classes to our kids. So I teach the welding, horticulture, vet assistant, and the upper level ag classes, which are the older kids. Mr. Delk is teaching electricity and carpentry and a power mechanics class that we were able to add this year. And Ms. Manuel's doing our Ag 1s and Ag 2s right now. So it really gives us a lot of freedom to offer our kids tons of opportunities to explore what's out there in the world once they get out of high school.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff.
That is a lot of stuff, it is.
All right, now the money raised at this event, now where does this money go?
All right, so we actually start selling fruit trees. Our students sell fruit trees prior to this day. And so we have about 400 pre-ordered fruit trees here.
Wow.
And then the plant sale, which the money generated off of that will be around $3,000 to $4,000. It just depends on how our sales go. We'll use that to put back into the activities of the chapter. We'll put, you know, if Mr. Delk needs some parts for his engines, he can get them from that. But a lot of the funds we raise, we put back into our program. So when we host events like Gatorade or we go out to Robert Farm and do some stuff with the kids, we buy the supplies for that. We do some educational stuff at the elementary schools, and we build gardens, and this pays for that kind of stuff. So
wow, that's amazing. Now, how many kids are involved in this?
We have close to 300 kids that take our classes. We have about 100 of them that actually get involved in the outside of the classroom stuff. Now, the trees, you know, with 400 trees, so you know, that was a lot of kids selling trees.
Wow.
And so it varies, and it gives a lot of the kids, they may take the class because they want to learn how to weld, and then they'll go over to ABC and they'll get some training. And
right,
I literally have a junior in high school that's making $18 an hour tacking, and he, you know, he's already ready for the workforce. He's a certified welder, and by the time he's graduated, he'll be, you know, making the big money.
And that's really neat that it's hands-on, because the kids, they planted these seeds.
Yes, sir,
right?
The kids, so all the vegetables are from seed. We plant those. We do buy the flowers as baby plugs,
yeah,
simply because we don't have the space to seed them out. When we would have to seed them way back in September or so,
right.
And we just don't have that space right now. So the kids, the upper level kids, my Ag 3 and Ag 4 kids, they'll do all the marketing, they'll do the signs, they make all the informational signs and stuff, and we get the younger kids to come in and help us plant the vegetables, plant the flowers and put them in the hanging baskets and do all of that. So
all right.
It's really a all-around event, hands-on, where everybody chips in to get it done.
Well, I've been here before. It was last year, I believe. I think just about everything in my garden came from here. So it's fixing to get really busy here, and we're fixing to get crowded, and we're going to see some people buying some plants. We're going to talk to some kids, and we're going to see behind the scenes of what's really going on here at the FFA. Thank you for stopping and talking with me.
Thanks.
And
appreciate
all the work you do.
Out.
Good job.
All right. Thank you.
All right, y'all. I got one of the patrons here coming to buy some plants. Let's get his name and where he's from.
Larry Dupree. I live right here in Santa Mar.
Larry Dupree. He's not kin to me, but he's a Dupree, though. I don't think we're kin, huh?
No, we're not kin. We
Same spelling.
Same spelling, yeah.
Wow. Now, what brought you out here?
I come out here every year and get my plants from the FFA.
Tell me what you got.
I got tomatoes, bell peppers, some cayenne peppers, squash.
That's a good-looking tomato. What variety did you get?
I'm trying a new one this year. It's that... I gotta find it.
Let's
on
see.
Here.
Number. Is it that Bella Rosa?
No, it's a hot. It's a solar.
Solar fire tomato.
Solar fire.
And that's first time you're growing that.
Yeah, they said they developed them around in this neighborhood, so I'm gonna try them out this year.
And that's what's really neat, y'all. Y'all can come out here and try some different stuff that you've never grown before, or maybe something they don't have at your local plant store. You know.
Right.
All right, well, I'm going to let you go home and do some planting.
All right, man.
Thank you.
See y'all later.
All right, y'all. Found one of the volunteers out here. Let's get her name and where she's from.
Rachel Bordelon. I'm from Santa Ma. I'm volunteering. Megan Bordelon is my daughter. She's president of FFA.
Oh, wow. Where's she at?
She is busy working, running around, getting things taken care of for today.
Now, what brings you out here? Do you like the plants, too?
I love plants.
So you bought some?
Not yet. I hope there are some left.
Oh, you better get some while you can.
I know. I got to hurry.
Now, people come up and buy just piles of it like this.
And
y'all got some of the most beautiful stuff out here.
Yes, you can buy them individually. You can buy them in a flat. They have vegetables and plants and flowers. So, yeah.
But, all right. I'm going to let you get back to work. Look like you need it at the register.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, y'all, made it to the back of the greenhouse back here, and I got the president of the FFA. Let's get her name and where she's from.
Megan Bordelon, and I'm from Santa Ma.
Now, you born and raised right here?
Yes, sir. I actually live right down the road from school.
Oh, neat. Now, you've been the president for 2 years, I hear?
2 years, yes, sir. I was actually the reporter my sophomore year, the president my junior year, and the president my senior year.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
Now, you was telling me that... Well, tell everybody, what do you do as president? What all do you do?
Okay, so we do a lot of stuff. I'm actually the head in charge, so everybody with any questions, come ask me. I make some decisions. I don't like making decisions by myself, but I sure do try to, you know, make sure everybody's leading in the right direction. I, you know, kind of spear all the events around here and make sure they're running smoothly.
Awesome. Now, you said you was busy doing, y'all had a different function last week.
Right. We had Gatorade last week, which was the day we had 14 different sites around the community, and we went and helped them in any way we could, just, you know, kind of like making it, sprucing up everything in the community.
Wow.
And then we also did the application last week, which will rank our state, our chapter, on a state level. And that's an application. You write up all the different things about your events and submit that, and they rank you. And actually, we're waiting and crossing our fingers that we're a gold emblem chapter.
So all that was going on while the seeds were getting planted.
Yes, sir. We were fortunate not have to do this part. I'm not a big fan on greening, and everybody in here should be thankful that I didn't plant their seeds because they might all be dead.
You
know? I did plant some of them back there.
There
were babies, and they're growing. So.
That's what they were saying. Y'all buy some of the little plugs and
like
plant them.
Big. They're so cute.
And they've grown up now.
Yes, sir.
All right. Y'all plan on selling everything today?
Oh, we're sure going to try.
All right. Well, thank you for taking time to stop and talk with me.
Thank you for being here. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody. It's that time of year again. The 3rd annual Junior's Meat Market Steak Cook-Off, July 30th. Come and sign up. 3 divisions this year, $20 for each category. Steak, pork ribs, and chicken. Food will be sold to the public. Music by the Kindler Brothers and Guests. Sign up at Junior's Meat Market. Cash and trophies awarded to the top 3 cooks in each category. Remember, there's only two things to do on the weekend, barbecue or boogaloo. We'll be looking for you.
Junior's Meat Market has everything you need when you're going to the camp, tailgating, or planning dinner. We make our own cracklings, beef jerky, hog-head cheese, and sausage right here in the store. We also process deer and hogs. Junior's Meat Market has an abundance of groceries and frozen items, which include crab cakes, fried oysters, tilapia, and more. We have daily meat specials, and we cook plate lunches every other weekend. Stop by Junior's Meat Market today and bring home dinner. Galvez Hardware and Outdoor Cooking is two unique stores in one. The hardware department has everything you need to fix stuff right. The outdoor cooking section cannot be beaten. We have all the latest and greatest gadgets on the market. But also, we keep a large stock of the tried and tested cookware we've all come to love over the years. Coffee and biscuits every morning during the week. Cooking demos on Saturdays. And customer service that will help you get the job done. RP Custom Trailers and Service is a fully stocked store for RV parts and accessories, with essentials such as tank treatments, hoses, lenses, vents, power cords, cleaning supplies, and everything else your camper may need. Known for customized living quarters and horse trailers for over 18 years. We now specialize in RV insurance work. Talk to Ryan about how to prevent blowouts, and oh yes, that leaky vinyl or rubber roof can be inspected and repaired also. Call or come by and see it all at RP Custom Trailers. Dreams Come True of Louisiana is a nonprofit organization that grants dreams to Louisiana children between ages 3 and 18 with a life-threatening illness. Dreams Come True was founded in 1982 by seven families in Denham Springs with a goal of providing dreams to children. All funding was initially provided by those families. Dreams Come True is proud to have one paid employee and provides dreams throughout the state of Louisiana. Dreams Come True provides an average of 65 to 70 dreams per year. Visit our website for more information, dctofla.com.
All right, y'all, I made it over to the pre-sold area where they pre-sell the trees. I got one of the teachers. Let's get his name and where he's from.
I'm Brennan Delk, and I'm from Walker, Louisiana. I teach here at Santa Maria High School, though, ag.
All right. Now, you're in charge of the pre-sale stuff.
Yes, sir. We saw every year we normally pre-sell around 300 to 400 fruit trees, all different varieties. They're all grafted plants. They're all disease-free.
Oh, wow.
So, We do really well with these fruit trees.
So people pre-sell them. They just show up today. They come to you. You write them off. Here we go with all the plants. And y'all had some left over there.
Yes, sir. We normally order about 80 to 100 extra trees because people always come in and they're asking. They come and browse these trees and they always want to pick one up while they're here. So
right.
we have the option.
So that's really neat, y'all. So next year, I guess at a certain time of the year, y'all start selling them?
Yes, sir. Normally about the middle of March, we'll start selling them. We sell them online. If you go to sandmallffa.com, you can put an online order in, and it'll be here when you get here.
How much are they?
They're $25 a piece, which is a little bit better than your average price if you go to like Tractor Supply, Lowe's, or
right.
anything like that.
Right. Well, that's neat, y'all. You can pre-order them. They take care of them, disease-free. Then you come out on the plant sale day and pick them up, and you'll have some of these guys out here helping you out. Thanks, man, for what you do.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, got one of the FFA members. Let's get his name and where he's from.
Blake Above and from Prairieville.
Now, you took part in planting a lot of these plants.
Yeah, it was me and we have Ag 3 and an Ag elective class that's together, so we decided to partner up and try to get as much as we can and as fast as we can, and it obviously worked out pretty well.
Yeah, you was telling me maybe 50 students about somewhere around
there. Yes, sir, around like 50 students. And we had other ag classes come out just a few days to make sure we were not running out of time.
Now, how long did it take to plan all of this?
Over
a matter of a day or 2 days or a week? Or
probably about a couple weeks.
A couple weeks.
We started at the beginning of second semester, so we came back from over the holiday break.
Well, it's neat to come back and see them now that they're grown up.
Yeah, yeah.
You think y'all sell everything?
We pretty much do. We pretty much sell everything that is in there.
You was involved last year?
Yes, sir.
And y'all sold out, huh?
Yeah.
Well, cool, bro. Well, thanks for taking the time to talk with me.
All right.
All right, y'all. I got some more customers out here. Let's get their names and where they're from.
Varma Templeton from Sanamo.
Adele Wren from Sorrento.
Now, have y'all been to this sale before?
Oh, yes. We look forward to it each year. I have a son that teaches here. He teaches, Darryl Babin teaches art here. So we like to support the school anyhow. But we would, I find out when it's going to be ahead of time from him. So we always plan to come out.
Now, I see y'all got a good little variety going right here. This is, I know some of these. Maybe you can help me with some. I see some tomatoes, maybe a squash, some peppers. Now, I don't know the flowers. Y'all know the names?
Viola is the only one I
know. Oh, that's Viola.
That's got purple and gold. You have to get something that
represents. Exactly. These are neat. Look, that's a neat-looking little
lantana.
Flower.
Lantana. I really like that.
Lantana.
It grows up into a nice bush, you know.
Gotcha. And you're going to put these at your house around in the flower beds?
Oh, yes.
And y'all grow a garden every year?
Oh, sure. That's good. About, you know, after you retire, you have to find a nice hobby.
Find something to do. Now, how'd your garden do last year? Did y'all grow good?
Oh, it did great.
It did? Mm-hmm. It did.
I have self-watering containers now.
Oh.
And so if I'm gone for a week, it keeps on watering itself.
Awesome. Well, that's what it takes, y'all people. The community coming out and supporting the school and buying. And that's what makes it go around. That's what makes a good sale, and that's what makes a good community.
These nice, healthy plants.
They're all beautiful. Yes, everything is nice. Well, I want to thank y'all for taking time and stopping and talking with me.
Sure thing. Thank you.
Thank y'all. All right, y'all. Got some more shoppers out here. Let's get their names and what school they go to. What's your name?
Kara.
And where do you go to school?
St. John Primary.
All right. What's your name?
Kaysen.
And what school you go to?
St. John Primary.
And let's get mom's name.
Christy.
From?
Sanamo, right here.
All right. Now, are y'all going to help her plant all these plants?
Yes.
Y'all like digging in the dirt?
Yes.
Yeah? Yeah. And y'all got mostly flowers. Y'all going to do some tomato plants or something too? Or y'all?
Their papa is going to do a big garden. They help her papa with the gardening.
Oh.
He does a huge garden every year. We do flowers.
You like picking the tomatoes and the cucumbers and all the good stuff? Yeah.
Tell them what you were just digging up the other day.
What were you digging?
Carrots.
Oh, really? Y'all had a fall garden then.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, thank y'all for stopping and talking with me.
Say thank you.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, got some more customers out here buying some plants. Let's get their names and where they're from.
Hi, I'm Ronnie Radford. I'm from Sanamo.
And your name?
My name's Ainsley. I'm from Sanamo, and I go to Sanamo Primary.
You go to Sanamo Primary?
Yes, sir.
Are you going to help plant some of these plants?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, what all y'all get? Y'all got a neat variety here.
We got peppermint.
Wow. I see tomatoes.
Tomatoes, peppers.
All kind of good stuff. Oh, y'all got all
lemon thyme. We're going to make this an herb garden.
An herb garden.
Yeah.
And you already have a place picked out where you're going to put it?
Yes, we have two raised bed gardens, so.
All right.
Yep.
Now, y'all grown before? I mean, do y'all always grow
this
stuff?
This is our second time, so we're hoping it'll turn out better this time than it did last year.
Do you eat tomatoes?
No.
No?
My grandmother does.
All right.
Yes, we're going to make Mama very happy.
All right. Well, thank y'all for stopping and talking.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, y'all, I got some of the FFA members right here. Let's get their names and where they're from.
I'm Tristan James. I'm from Santa Monica, Louisiana.
My name is Austin Jackson. I'm from Darrow, Louisiana.
Awesome. Now, y'all took part in planting some of these plants?
Yes, sir. The ag classes planted them, and I was involved in ag class last semester, which I helped plant some after school because I'm the 2015-16 secretary for FFA, and we're the one that hosts the whole plant sale and plant it.
Awesome. Now, you got your hands dirty in these plants?
Yeah, I was in my fourth block for Miss Manuel at Ag 2 class.
Awesome. Now, tell me some of the other things y'all do with FFA.
Okay, so we have many events with FFA throughout the year. One event we do is our Brew of the Born event, which is where we collect canned goods and food and monetary donations for our food insecure families.
Oh, wow.
Where we have a backpack program where there's students at our school that need that are food insecure at their home. So every Friday we send them home with a backpack, and it's anonymous, so they think it's, everybody else thinks it's just their school backpack to make it through the weekend for
them. That's cool. That is really cool.
And then this year we did our first Christmas give, which we collected presents and different donations from different clubs we partnered with to donate them. And we gave them, we had a big event in the library. We served a gumbo to families that were nominated, and we gave the gifts just to make their holiday season a little more cheerful for them.
Wow, y'all do some neat stuff.
Yes, sir.
Now, I want to thank y'all for stopping the plant sale here and talking with me, and y'all keep up the good work, fellas.
Yes, sir.
Thank y'all. All right, y'all, something I want to tell all the viewers out there. I always wanted to do some garden stuff and do a neat garden shows and show gardening, but the opportunity has come about now, and we're starting a new show, Cajun Living and Cooking, in conjunction with Taylor Fry Productions. Taylor Fry is going to be the host of the show. Something y'all may not know or may have heard about, that the Ascension Parish Schools received a grant from PCS Nitrogen. So they're growing gardens at 13 schools in Ascension Parish. And they're in conjunction with the LSU Ag Center and the Master Gardeners, and also Mr. Craig Roussel out at the Ag Center, and Miss Kiki Fontenot out at the LSU. And they've all come together through the teachers and the schools, and the show is gonna be about these kids learning to garden in these raised beds. So they brought in the dirt, they brought in the seeds, and the show will be airing, it's probably be airing right now, that Taylor Fry will be the host, and we're gonna somewhat teach the community how to grow gardens through these kids learning how to grow gardens through the raised beds. And we're gonna go through the rigors of planting and the disease, and also the troubles that they have, and then go through the Ag Center, how to fix the troubles, and then all the way down to harvesting the fruit from the tomatoes or cucumbers, or even digging up potatoes. And then I believe at the end we're gonna do some cooking at the schools, and the kids will get to eat it. So y'all be looking for that. It's called Growing Gardens. It's gonna be on ETEL, and it's gonna be something really neat. You're gonna have to check this out and learn how to grow gardens with the kids.
Hey everybody, it's that time of year again. The 3rd Annual Junior's Meat Market State Cook-Off, July 30th. Come and sign up. 3 divisions this year, $20 for each category. Steak, pork ribs, and chicken. Food will be sold to the public. Music by the Kindler Brothers and Guests. Sign up at Junior's Meat Market. Cash and trophies awarded to the top 3 cooks in each category. Remember, there's only 2 things to do on the weekend, barbecue or boogaloo. We'll be looking for you.
Miss D's Sweet Sensations is a wholesale sweet shop located in Sanibel, Louisiana. The business is locally owned and operated by Diane Bro, now with 12 delicious varieties to choose from. You can find Mrs. D's Sweet Sensations in all of your local supermarkets and convenience stores. Made fresh daily by 6 full-time employees, right here in Ascension Parish. Hey, store owners, restaurants, and caterers, if you're not selling Mrs. D's Sweet Sensations, you're not selling the best product on the market. Lamar Dixon Expo Center, the crown jewel of Ascension Parish, supporting community development and charitable organizations. The center offers a wide variety of activities, such as outside show arenas, fully equipped barns, a newly renovated 4-H building, an Acadian-style chapel, RV parking with bathhouses, and large and small banquet rooms, just to name a few. Located in Gonzales and surrounded by hotels, restaurants, and great shopping venues. Come enjoy what Lamar Dixon Expo Center has to offer.
TrueFab, a fabrication and welding service shop located in Gonzales, Louisiana. Committed to quality, on-time delivery per ASME and AWS codes with on-staff CWI. Specializing in pipe fabrication, manufacturing, and specialty structural steel fabrication. Serving the industry with over 50 years of combined welding, industrial construction, and fabrication experience. TrueFab provides a cost-effective outsourced solution for manufacturers. Simply put, our commitment to your satisfaction keeps you as a valued customer. TrueFab. Building industry partnerships.
Hole in the Wall Seafood and Cajun Meats now has more to offer. The same high-quality seafood, live and boiled crawfish, crabs, sack oysters, frog legs, shrimp, gator meat, gore balls, and local catfish, just to name a few. Now selling your favorite smokehouse products. Homemade sausage and andouille, beef jerky, stuffed pork chops and chickens, fried boudin balls, cracklings, and much more. Now processing your deer and hogs. And come check out our new seating area. Fred's on the River, the Amy River in Prairieville. Started as a bait shop and has evolved into a legendary place for music and dancing. The new double boat launch has been complete, with lots of parking for boats of all sizes. And the food mart offers convenient gas, food, and condiments for your day on the river. Happy hour 5 to 7, Tuesday through Friday. Karaoke every Friday night 8 to 12, with pool tables and video games. Band starts April 10th and run through the summer on Saturday and Sunday nights. Hope to see you at Fred's for a fun and exciting time.
All right, y'all, got some more customers here buying up some stuff. Let's get their names and where they're from.
Sarah Malonson from Santa Ma.
Chase Malonson from Santa Ma.
Judd Malonson from Santa Ma Primary School.
What's your name, buddy?
He don't want to say. Who's he?
He's Jeb.
All right. He's usually the talker, I bet.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I see y'all bought some pears and what we got here? Blueberries?
Yes. Blueberries.
I heard blueberries you got to plant too.
I hear you got to plant them together.
Yeah, they pollinate. That's what I've been hearing that forever. I want to plant some blueberries too. Now, y'all got some vegetable plants too?
Yes.
Y'all grow a garden every year?
We try.
We haven't the last few years. It's been a little difficult trying to take care of a garden and that one.
Now, what brings y'all here to come to this?
Well, we're from Santa Ma. We both graduated from Santa Ma. Our kids go to Santa Ma. So it's just nice to support such a good thing that Miss Mandy puts together.
And they have some really beautiful plants here.
They do.
Mm-hmm. Well, I want to thank y'all for stopping and supporting. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, got some more customers out here. Let's get their names and where they from.
My name is Sarah Blank, and I'm from Gonzales.
Hi, I'm Troy Blank, and I'm from Gonzales.
Now, y'all been doing some shopping. Y'all got a whole buggy full over here.
Getting ready for spring and summer.
Do y'all come to the sale every year? Or?
This is my first time, but I think she's
you
a
do?
Regular.
Yeah. I usually order, you know, like a fruit tree or something, and in the past, they've delivered it, but I think their business has grown, so they don't get to deliver anymore. Yeah. I had to come and get what I wanted this year.
They sold a bunch this year of over 300 and almost 400 trees. Now, you got a thornless?
Blackberry.
Thornless blackberry. Now, it grows the big ones, huh?
Big fat ones. That's
what All right. And this here, this
These are some lantana. They're really hard to kill.
Oh, really? Is that a shade or is that a sun?
It's for sun, and they kind of creep, and they help keep away mosquitoes.
Okay, and I seen you have a couple vegetable plants in there too. You're gonna mm-hmm. try
some have some
tomatoes?
Bell peppers, and uh-huh. I got some Creole tomatoes this time. I just use pots. I don't have a great big vegetable garden, but I like to keep them in pots.
It's easier to maintain when you only got a few, two or three. It's harder when you got a whole jungle full out there trying to take care of. Well, thank y'all for stopping and talking with me.
Absolutely, it was a pleasure.
Thank y'all. Mm-hmm. All right, y'all, we had a good time out here at Santa Ma High. It was the FFA annual plant sale, and it's really unique. The way they do this, the kids come out and help them, and the community comes out and buys stuff, really good stuff. Next year, order y'all's fruit trees when they come out, and I want y'all to come to the plant sale and support these kids who in turn raise money to help the community. And I want to thank y'all for watching Cajun Living and Cooking.